I would like to briefly introduce linear programming and show you a really quick example. So here's the idea. Let's say that you have a factory that produces washers and dryers. Let's call x the number of washers you produce and y the number of dryers you produce. And because of the way your machinery operates, there are a couple of constraints on how many washers and dryers you can produce in any given day. I'll make a couple up. If you went ahead and graphed those constraints on an xy plane using the skills from the previous video, they would look like this. Because your factory is going to produce more than zero washers and zero dryers, the number of washers and dryers that you can possibly produce falls into this region right here, which we more generally call the feasible region. The corners of the feasible region are called vertices. Okay, and now let's say that we have some function that we want to either maximize or minimize. Let's say we have a profit function that we want to maximize. A profit function might look something like this. This particular profit function says that for every washer we're going to produce, we're going to make $4, and for every dryer that we're going to produce, we're going to make $6. And we would like to maximize our profits. Okay, now generally speaking, the function that we want to either maximize or minimize is called an objective function. Well, the fundamental principle of linear programming says that if we have an objective function that looks like this, the maximum or minimum values of this objective function will occur at these vertices of the feasible region. In other words, if we want to maximize our profit for this washer and dryer factory, we are going to plug all of the values for the vertices into our profit function. So let me clean this picture up a little bit. We want to find all of the values for all of our vertices. Now, actually finding the values for these vertices is a different video and a different topic. If you want to look into it, look up solving systems of linear equations. But I'll just give you these values of the vertices here. And now we want to plug each one of those vertices into our objective function or our profit function. Let's start with the vertex 0, 0. If we plug x equals 0 and y equals 0 into our profit function, and simplify, we just get 0 for our profit. I have a feeling that that's the vertex where we're going to minimize our profits by making no washers and no dryers. What if we plug in the vertex 4, 0? Well, our profit function would look like this. 4 times 4 would give us 16, 6 times 0 would give us 0, so our profit here would be $16. How about the vertex 0, 6? Plugging in x equals 0 and y equals 6 gives us this, which simplifies to $36 profit. And our last vertex is the one with the fractions. Plugging our x and y values into the profit function gives us this, and to do that calculation, I'm going to bring up a calculator. And my calculator is giving us a profit of $34 and about 86 cents. So our largest profit number is $36 per day. So for this particular problem with these particular numbers, to maximize profit, we want to make 0 washers and 6 dryers per day. Okay, I just wanted to keep this video short. I think that tells you about everything you need to know about linear programming for this course. So we'll stop things there, and I will see you in the next one.